But since then, a Leicester boy discovered, the Wigston Bell School, discovered a fossil in the 12th class, which proved at the time to be the earliest becoming fossil. We know something that's older now, but at the time. So the name that he got was Charlie, after Charlie. And you're Australian?
No, no. I spent last year in Australia. What? But, I spent the previous year in Australia.
I was in Australia, and the Australian paleontologist said to me, look, that's one of the oldest fossil plates called Charlie. And I said, yes, I know it's called Charlie. Do you know why it's called Charlie? What's the name? And he said, no. And I said, well, I'll tell you. Because it's found, the type specimen is found in Charlie. Okay, one more hand.
Do you think it's likely we'll find descendants of a bigger species on land and sea in the future?
A bigger species?
Yeah.
It becomes increasingly unlikely. If we're talking about land species, because if you're going to move about on land, you have to have some sort of structure to help you move. If you're going to be weighing 7 tons, that's got to be fairly substantial stuff. In other words, you've got to have bones. And bones have, bone itself, the material, has a limit on its strength. There is a limit after, beyond which the weight is put on it, it will crumble. And that enables you to say,